You might be familiar with some cool projects in electronics and heard this term Arduino and might be wondering what Arduino is. So here is an overview video of Arduino microcontroller board. In this brief tutorial, we will understand what Arduino is, types of Arduinos, Arduino hardware, software used to program Arduino, different extensions of Arduino, and a few examples of Arduino projects. Basically everything that you wanted to know about Arduino. So let's get started. First of all, what is Arduino, you might ask? Arduino is an Italian-based software and hardware ecosystem which was found by 5 students as a part of their project at Interaction Design Institute. This company designs and sells microcontroller-based boards along with an integrated development environment, that is IDE. This is their own software which we will discuss further in this video. These boards and software are open source, means all the designs are available for commercial use. That means you can make your own prototype based on Arduino and sell it. But before you do anything for commercial use, make sure you read all the necessary policies on arduino.cc. This was a little brief information about the company Arduino. Now, you would ask what microcontroller is. So, a microcontroller is basically like a mini computer. It has a dedicated RAM, memory, input-output pins, which you could control it according to your program and application. So, now let's talk about Arduino hardware. There are lots of official versions of Arduino boards, like most popular and versatile Arduino Uno, Arduino Nano, which is basically a smaller version of Uno, Arduino Mega, Lilypad, etc. You can find the list in the Arduino website. But here we will discuss about Arduino Uno in brief, since Uno is beginner friendly and quite easy board to get started with. Okay, so Arduino Uno is a microcontroller based prototyping board which has 32 kilobytes of memory and 2 kilobytes of RAM, which is based on Atmel's 80 Mega 328P, which runs at 16 MHz of clock frequency. Arduino Uno has digital I/O pins on the right side, a few analog input pins on the left side, PWM outputs, power pins, female DC input port, female USB type B port, voltage regulator, microchip, and a serial communication chip. So, digital I/O pins. They are used to read and write binary, that is 0 volt, or binary 1, that is 5 volts, to these pins from pin number 2 to 13. They can be easily programmed using the IDE. Analog inputs. These pins can read an analog voltage from 0 volts to 5 volts and convert it from 0 to binary 10. That is from 0 to 1023, which you can refer it as 0 to 10 bit. Pulse width modulation I/O pins. Pulse width modulation I/O pins lets control the intensity of, say, like LEDs, motors, etc. They are generally marked with a tilde sign, or you can say like a wave. Power pins. Here we have two ground pins, a 3.3 volt pin, a 5 volt pin, which can be either used to power external components or Arduino itself by giving 5 volts to it. Remember, each Arduino I/O port is capable of delivering 20 milliamps of current. Do not exceed this limit by using high current motors or something like that. It will burn the Arduino. Female DC input port. This is used to power Arduino Uno using an adapter or a battery. Female USB type B port. This is another way to power Arduino Uno board, or you can use this to program 80 Mega 328P chip. Now, moving on to software. IDE stands for Integrated Development Environment, which is basically a software environment that allows you to program your Arduino according to your requirement. You would say, what is so special about that? Let me tell you, for other microcontroller boards like 8051, just to write a simple addition code, you are expected to know assembly language, which is quite difficult to understand and memorize. Here, in Arduino IDE, you can write complex codes in very simple way. You might need to refer to syntax at www.arduino.cc/reference/en. Now, for installation of this Arduino IDE, first of all, go to www.arduino.cc or you can simply Google Arduino software. Follow the installation procedure and once installed, plug in the Arduino Uno using the female USB Type-B port. Once you open your IDE for the first time, you should see a blank program or a workspace. Click on the Tools menu from the top bar, go to the board and now select the appropriate board, which in this case is an Arduino Genuino slash Uno. Click on Tools from the top menu, go to the port and now select port to which your Arduino is connected. For my case, it is COM port number 3. For this tutorial, I'll take an example of blinking LED. We will blink the LED on pin number 13, which is usually inbuilt LED on the Uno board. Here, we have two main sections of code, that is void setup and void loop. In void setup, you would set your input-output pins and define variables. In void loop, you would describe your function to IO pins or build logic like conditional statements, etc. For our blink program, I will simply mention pin mode in setup and output states in loop to blink along with a delay. Once you get this, save your code. Then click on verify, which looks like a check button. Now, press the upload button if successfully verified. Once you have successfully uploaded your Arduino code, you will observe that LED on pin number 13 is blinking, which means that the board is properly working. With our first successful upload, let's proceed to a little advanced stage, that is extensions. Now, we have learned the very basics of Arduino. We can also use sheilds on our Arduino, which are basically like extensions to I/O ports and carry a few integrated components like LCD, 7-segment display, sensors, etc. There are lots of extensions available like Bluetooth modules, Wi-Fi shields, displays, etc. Here is a little demonstration of a countdown timer on a multi-purpose sheild. Now moving on to more examples, there are lots and lots and lots of examples I need to show you guys, but you guys have already seen a lot on the internet as the Arduino community is creative and vast. Still, I have a little examples that you will enjoy. On. Off. On. We'll be right back. Guys, there are lots and lots of more Arduino based projects coming on this channel soon, so stay tuned to check them out. If you enjoyed this video, please do recommend this to your friends and do subscribe to Mission Critical.